Welcome everybody. So today in our third module, construction disputes and settlements, we are going to discuss about cost estimation. So let us see the cost estimating tools and techniques. What is analogous estimating? Using the actual cost of previous or similar projects as the basis for estimating the cost of the current project. So if you are doing a project from the past experience, from the previous experience, or from the cost estimated for similar projects, that will be the basis for your estimation for the current project. That is called analogous estimating. So analogous cost estimating uses expert judgment. See, even if you use the cost estimated from the previous jobs or previous projects or from your previous experience, day by day the unit rate varies. The material cost is changing, the labor cost is changing, etc. So based on that, you need expert judgment while you are doing analogous cost estimation. Analogous cost estimating is frequently used to estimate costs when there is a limited amount of detailed information about the project. So normally, we go for detailed project estimation. So if any of the data is missing, if your detailed information, any of the detailed information is missing, then for that purpose you can go for analogous cost estimating. So analogous cost estimating means estimating from the past experience, generally less costly than other techniques, generally less accurate. So determination of resource cost rates. How can you determine the cost rate of resources? So for each resource to estimate schedule activity cost. So you know resources means it may be men, material, machine, money, etc. So for each resource, you have to estimate the schedule activity costs. Standard rates with escalation factors can be included in the contract. Then obtaining data from commercial databases and seller published price lists is another source of cost rates. So how can you get the cost rates of various resources? So you can get it from the governmental databases or the seller price list which has been published. Now, what are the data you require for estimating? So the first data for cost estimation in a construction project is the drawings. You need the plan, section, elevation and detailed drawings of your project. Then second data you require is the general and detailed specifications of your project. And the third data you require is rates. That is unit rates for every resources, rate for the land acquired, etc. So the rate for each and every element involved in the project. So these are the data you need for cost estimating in a construction industry. Now, let us see what are the types or methods of estimating. So first type of estimation is called preliminary cost estimate. So preliminary cost estimate is also known as approximate cost estimate or abstract cost estimate or rough cost estimate. So what is preliminary or approximate estimate? So this estimate is required for preliminary studies of various aspects of the work or project to decide the financial position and policy for administration sanction by the competent administrative authority. So if you need for sanction, getting sanctioned of a project, initial sanction of a project, we will go for this rough cost estimator. Then you will submit the document for your preliminary approval from the authorities. So that is the purpose of this preliminary cost estimate. So second type of cost estimate is plinth area estimate. So in this plinth area estimate, here the estimate is prepared on the basis of plinth area of the building. So the rate for such estimate will be deducted from the cost of similar buildings having similar specifications, heights and construction in that particular locality. Okay, so plinth area estimate will be calculated by finding the plinth area of the building and multiplying the plinth area rate. So you multiply the plinth area of the building and the plinth area rate, you will get the plinth area estimate. Next is cube rate or cubical content estimating. So this cubical rate estimate is also a preliminary estimate or an approximate estimate. And here this estimate is prepared on the basis of cubical contents of the building. And the cubical rate, that is for 1 meter cube, what is the rate? That is what is called the cubical rate estimate. Estimating per cubic unit of the material. Material or resources, generally we call it as resources. Then fourth type of estimate is approximate quantity method estimate. So here the approximate total length of the walls is found in running meter. So walls normally we measure in terms of meter, right? So here in approximate quantity method estimate, you measure the length of the wall. So this wall length multiplied by the rate per running meter of the wall, it will give you the approximate quantity method estimate. And for doing this approximate quantity method estimate, your structure may be divided into two parts. So that is a foundation, including the plinth and the superstructure. Okay, to find the running rate for foundation, the approximate quantities of items such as excavation, foundation, brickwork up to plinth, and damp proof force need to be calculated per running meter. So you multiply these elements, multiply it by the rate of these items, you will get the approximate quantity method estimate. Similarly, you can find the estimate for the superstructure also. Then fifth type of estimate is called a detailed estimate or item rate estimate for each item. Okay, so this detailed estimate is an accurate estimate, and this detailed estimate, it consists of working out the quantities of each item of works. So you find each items, then multiply the cost for each items. So here the dimensions, namely the length, breadth and height of each item, are taken out correctly from the drawings, and the quantities for each items are calculated and abstracting is done. Now the detailed estimate can be of two stages, that is details of measurements and calculation of quantities. See here, in detailed estimate we have two steps. First step is calculation of quantities, second step is calculation of cost. Next, sixth type of estimate is revised estimate. So revised estimate is also a detailed estimate, and this revised estimate is required to be prepared under any of the following situations arises. That is, when the original sanctioned estimate is exceeded or it is likely to exceed by more than 5%. Okay, so So when the original sanctioned estimate exceeds by 5%, we go for revised estimator. Second case, when the expenditure of the work exceeds the administrative sanctioned amount by more than 10%, we go for revised estimate. Then if there is any material deviations, that is other than the material for which you got sanctioned, you have to go for revised estimate. So that is the purpose of revised estimate. This is also a detailed estimator. Now, the seventh type of estimate is supplementary estimate. Supplementary estimate is also a detailed estimate. And this is prepared when additional works are required to supplement the original work. That is, see, in order to progress the work, if some more further development, you have to include the latest technologies which has come into force and for which you have not got any permission earlier. So in that case, we will go for supplementary estimate. Then eighth estimate is a supplementary and a revised estimate. Here both, see, you have sixth type is revised estimate, seventh type is a supplementary estimate. So a combination of both, so that is supplementary and revised estimate. So here the important thing is when a work is partially abandoned, partially stopped, and the estimated cost of the remaining work is less than 95% of the original work, then we go for supplementary or revised estimate. Supplementary and revised estimate. In simple, if a work is abandoned or stopped at the earlier stages of the work, only when 5% of less than 5 or 10% of the work has been completed. So major part of the work has to be done later. So in that case, you will go for supplementary and revised estimate. And last type of estimate is annual repair or maintenance estimate. So this is also a detailed estimate that has to be prepared to maintain the structure or work in progress. So that you can have a proper order and safe condition of your project. So that is called annual repair and maintenance estimator. So these are the nine types of estimating the cost in the construction industry. Now, what is unit rate costing of resources? Resources, you know, resources means it is men, material, machinery and money. So it can be men, it can be material, it can be machinery. For each unit, you have to get the cost of each unit of men, each unit of material, each unit of machineries. And then you have to cost it. You can multiply by the, multiply it with the unit rate. So that is called unit rate costing of resources. Now, a unit rate contains the average amount of resources you need to install one place. It can be measured in terms of piece, meter, kilogram, etc. And by multiplying all unit rates by the quantities, a very detailed estimate of the project resources is obtained. You have already studied and you have done problems on detailed estimate in your previous semesters, right? So that this will be very, you will be very aware of this topic. So this amount of granularity allow you to adjust productivity per work activity. And assigning each activity to a section of the work breakdown structure used for scheduling, a resource distribution is obtained that allows the business to actively trace and control on productivity. Thank you for today. So today's class we have seen about the construction cost estimation. In the next class we will be seeing about the budget. Thank you for today. Thank you.